Oh, Lord, you bless him.
Let's go to the Lord in prayer.
Yes, mighty Lord.
Father, we bow before you, Lord. Yes, we thank you for this day. We thank you, Father, for each one that's come out to pay the respects to Dorothy and her family, Father. We pray that as Brother Cecil brings the word today, that the word might bring comfort to
us. Yes, mighty Lord.
Nothing else can, Lord, like you do. So we want to thank you for all that you do for us. We've got so many things to be thankful for. Got so many things on our mind to pray about. It's a time of sadness. It's a time of joy. People in mixed emotions.
Yes, mighty Lord.
Many people, Lord, are in the valley of decision. And we pray that you might help them through your word, Lord. The word touches people's hearts.
Yes, sweet Jesus.
I pray you'd help us to realize that we need to have a closer walk with you, Lord, that we might have power with you, that we can talk to mankind and maybe lead someone to you.
Yes, mighty Lord.
We pray, Father, that you comfort the family. We pray for our country, Lord. It's in a terrible mess. And we just pray that you be the leaders of it, Lord. And this virus that's going around has almost shut folks down. Just help us to trust you, Lord.
Yes,
you
mighty Lord.
Lift that in your own time. You do things good, and you'll do anything that comes along. It's in your way, in your time. If it's not, it's not worth anything. So we ask, Father, that you might be with us today as we, as Brother Cecil preaches this.
Yes, mighty Lord.
And as we go to the graveside, whatever it might be, you might get the honor and glory for everything in our lives. If there's any here that's sick or maybe,
yes, Lord.
If there's anybody here that don't know you as Savior, that you might touch your heart today, Lord, and turn to you. We realize how soon your coming must be. Thanks for your love and your mercy and your watch care now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Dorothy Sue Van Winkle, age 71, on Scaffold Road, passed away Monday, August the 17th, 2020, at the Hospice Comprehensive Care Center in Richmond. Dorothy was born in Maria, Kentucky, to the late Allison and Marie Reed. She worked at the Environmental Services at the Maria Hospital for 47 years before retiring. She also attended the Bethel Baptist Church. In addition to her parents, she was also preceded in death by her siblings, Earl Joe Reed, David Reed, and Larry Reed, and Gary Reed, and Danny Reed. She is survived by her husband for 47 years, Larry Van Winkle. Her two children, Tammy Van Winkle and Dallas Mark, the Patricia Van Winkle. Her siblings, Johnny Harold and Shelby Reed, Carrie Edna and the Junior Waitress, Peggy Lynn and Hansel Clemens, Rick and Sharon Reed, Doris James and Cromer, and Patty Coy Vance, and multitude of nephews and nieces, and great nieces and great nephews that she cared very deeply for. She is also survived by her uncle Billy Reed and Aunt Dolores Powell, and two special sister-in-laws, Margaret Van Winkle and Merlin Cope. And the Paul Burgett gives their names out, but they know who those are. So
amen.
This time we'll turn the services over.
God bless you, my brother. Good speaking.
I'm kind of homesick for a country to which I've never been before.
Oh, yeah.
No sad goodbyes will there be spoken. And time won't matter anymore. Beulah Lane, I'm longing for you. And someday on the outstanding eternal, beautiful land. Across the river to where my faith will end inside. There's just a few more days to labor, then I will take
Mark in the hallway. She'd say, let's pray. She loved to pray. Folks, if there's ever a time in America we need to pray. You know, we can't say no more for Dorothy. But you know what? We help one another. You know, if you really know where she was at, you know, nobody knows her heart, do they? But God. And you know what? If she was here, she would think. Listen to this song now. Think about this. I'm ready to claim my wardrobe in heaven, tailored for me, just the right size. I'll dress like a king. I'll walk with the angels. Good morning up there and never goodbye. Well, the street is pure. There's nothing but happiness. The presence of Christ abounds everywhere, on top of the hill and down by the river. One day I will join that heavenly choir, 'cause I'm ready to claim my wardrobe in heaven, tailored for me, just the right size. I'll dress like a king, I'll walk with the angels, good morning up there and never goodbye. You know, if we could really realize what's really, you know, I believe Dorothy deserves the best, don't you? And you know, I don't have anything. She's one of the ladies that I've only got something good to say about, Mark. And you know what? That's what we are. You know, she's at a place, I'm sure in my heart, she went to heaven because she always prayed. Pray for my husband. He gave his heart to the Lord. Pray for my son. He gave his heart. And you know what? She must know you's okay. Because, you know, this is, folks, I mean, we do a lot of funerals. I done my daddy's funeral, my mother's funeral, my sister's funeral, my brothers. But one thing about it, honey, they're all. One thing we need to realize, we're in a time. I'm sorry I don't have a mask on, but sure can't preach with a mask on. So you tell Brother Bashir I can't get it done today, okay? This thing is real and alive because there's people here. That's sad. There's people here that's hurting. But one thing about it, I've got a God that's alive. I got a God that in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 1 says, when this earthly tabernacle, my brother, I appreciate you, my brother, you know, when this earthly tabernacle is dissolved, I got a heavenly tabernacle awaiting on you. Not made by man's hands, but made by God's hands. You know what, folks? You know what the Lord wants for us? He wants us to be happy. He said, peace I give unto you, peace I leave with you, not as the world giveth, but I want to give it to you. You know, I was 34 years old before the Lord got a hold of me. Yeah, I was a pure little outlaw. People know me, they know what I was. But one thing about it, in 84, he got a hold of me. And I'm going to tell you, there was a different me. I seen everything different. You know, if there's anybody here today that don't know you got a home in heaven, you know, she want me to sing this song for her. If I get there before you do, I'll be looking for you. I'll just wait till the Lord calls me home. We've had victories and tears. We've been blessed with many years. Now we'll spend eternity with our Lord. And we'll walk hand in hand throughout the promised land, down the streets made of purest of gold. I'm so glad we made the choice. Jesus Christ is still the Lord. Son of love, I'll be looking for you. You know, God made her a promise that her family would be there with her. You know, am I preaching to heaven? No. I just, in my own heart, I feel like that's where she's at. The Revelator said there'll be no more tears, no more heartache where she's at. You know what, folks? I think we need to look. And you know, everybody wants to, did you ever notice everybody wants to look at the bad stuff, Mark? I want to look at the good stuff. You look at the good stuff. That's a good mother, wouldn't she? That's a good wife, wouldn't she? So, you know, she deserves the best. And you know that, too. I hadn't met you much, but anyway, God is here to bless every one of you. If he could save me, hey, he could save you. Because I know, honey, I'm a bronc rider, a bull rider from the west, and I know that if he can get a hold of me and do with me what he done, you know, I can't even read the way. I'll tell you why I can quote every scripture in here about it. Because God is alive. He tells us, I stand up here and preach you hellfire and damnation, but what? This ain't the time. This sister needs, hey, she needs the best, don't she, Mark? She needs somebody to say, you know, good things about her. Hell is real, but it's not for you. It's your choice. I like that decision the brother said, talked about a while ago. We've got to make a decision, no matter how old we are, how young we are, we've got to make a decision where we're going one day. And you know what, folks, the way this old stuff, many people live in this world on account of this Corona 19 stuff. You know, the devil's turned loose. You know what? I know a God that can calm the storm. I know a God that can peel the water back and let you walk through on dry land. You know, I'm not supposed to be here. But the Lord said, I want you to stand up because you will. You stand up and tell them I love them. You stand up and tell them this thing is real and alive. Folks, it is. I feel the presence of God here. And no matter what time it is, no matter where it's at, if you want to pray, you raise your hand. We'll get to you. Because God is right here for you. He loves you more than life. You know, you don't hear it now. Support a governor, a president, support them all. But you don't hear the name of the Lord mentioned much. Jesus is his name. You know why? He died on that cross. He rose again. You can't take that out of me because, honey, he changed my life. You know, oh, no, I'm not perfect. Come on, I make mistakes every day. I kicked a little duck in the pond the other day. But one thing about it, he still loves you. No matter who you are, what you are, he loves you. And, you know, I think all lives matter. I really do. Because he's standing there with open arms for you and me. You know, just like he did those. Come unto me, all ye that labor and heavy laden. I'm going to give you rest. You know, I told Mark we was going to have church. He looked at me and shook his head. I love him. But you know what? There ain't no way that we can love like Jesus Christ did. Fathers, we come into your mighty loving name. Lord, I pray the good word said. I know, God, that you're still alive and you're still with us. Oh, there's none of this disease too big for you because you said you come to fulfill it all, and I believe that. I believe we're praying for the sister churches that's hurting, Lord. I lift your name up because your name is higher than any other name. Lord, bless this family and comfort them. I feel the blessing, and I know it's you. I know, Lord, that you want us to use wisdom. But one thing about it, we're going to talk to you today. Lord, if there be one here lost, let them come to you. I feel your drawing. If there be one here sick, Lord, let your anointing and your Holy Ghost come down and just move upon them. Bless this family, Lord. I feel your blessings, and I know it's you. Never fail to praise you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Springtime. to see the pretty flowers bloom. And every day she whispered, "Thank you, Lord." She could see them from the window in her room. Now and again her children came to see her, but not as often as she would have liked. Her smile was like a golden ray of sunshine. She was living in the winter of her life. The doctor said it was drawing nearer. Her children came to sit close by her side. They whispered, "What is there anything that we can do for you?" She held her hands and this was her reply. "Don't cry for me, I'm going home to see my Savior. There's a garden he's been tending just for me. Roses on the vine. Dry your eyes,
dry your eyes.
Don't you cry,
don't you cry.
I'm just going where it is forever springtime."
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the service here at the funeral home. We're going to get ready to go to our cars. We're going to get ready to go to the cemetery. What we're going to do is I'm going to open up the back door. Of course, the main door to the funeral home is open. We're going to start at the back of the room, folks. We'll just let you dismiss and go right on out. We'll have, let the family have a little private.